Tell me what you play. I haven't seen it yet.
I play Victor Budarin. I'm a henchman for the Division, which is run by...
You're a bad guy.
I'm a bad guy, yeah. And I have telekinetic powers. I'm a mover, so I can lift and throw things with my mind bullets. Yeah.
How do you portray that on screen, where you're doing things with your mind?
We did a lengthy process of trying to work out how this would look, because my character can repel bullets just by setting up a force field in front of him. He can lift and throw things with his powers. So we went through a long process of how does that look? Does he just, is it small, nonchalant movements? And we ended up deciding that there's an element of effort. If he wants to pick something up that's heavy, there's an element of effort to throw. So you'd still have to exert some sort of thing. And it ends up being this very physical expression of his power, which I really like.
Now, there was a lot of, not a lot of blue screen or green screen. This was a lot of practical stuff. So did you do all your own stunts?
I did. Yeah, I did. I did all my own stunts. I had a stunt guy who sort of worked really well with me. I used to be a boxer, so a lot of the fight stuff came second nature.
You used to be a boxer?
Yeah. Yeah, so there's a lot of fight stuff came second nature to me, and the stunt guys worked with me really well. I mean, they're the unsung heroes of this movie. I mean, there's moments where I'm lifting stuff up and throwing it, but instead of it being green screen that then you suddenly see later on, it's actually two guys being lifted up in the air on wires and smashed into a wall 30 feet away. And every time I do, especially the last fight, I'm doing these movements with my hands like this, and some guy's flying that way, some guy's flying that way, and it's all thanks to these stunt guys that make it look believable and incredible. The pressure was that if I got my timing off with their wire pulls off, we had to reset and go again. So these guys were getting beaten up, and I had to apologize. But it's an amazing feeling when you're actually doing this, and people are flying through the air.
Yeah.
It starts to become easy to believe you actually have the powers. You'd be walking outside doing this, trying to get people out of your way in traffic.
It just doesn't work.
No, not so much.
Did it look on the screen how you expected it to look?
I haven't seen it yet. All I've seen is the trailer, so this is going to be the first time. I hope so. The trailer, the little bits in the trailer that I've seen of the stuff that I did look incredible. I mean, there's a bit where I'm smashing Chris Evans up against pillars and things, and the stunt guy on that guy, he got beaten the hell out of. Yeah, he was a hardy guy. And I love the way he gets up and dusts himself off after being smacked off pillars and ceilings and going, "Do you want another one?" He'd do like four or five more of them. I'm in pain for him just watching him, and all I'm doing is I'm getting wrist cramp just doing that.
Nice. You get like tendonitis or something.
I know, exactly. Can we stop? I got a boo-boo. Yeah.
Did you study any of this stuff? Like, because some of this is based on real experiments, right?
Yeah. I didn't study it for the script. I didn't get a chance to, unfortunately. I was shooting a movie before in London, and I got cast the day I finished the movie and flew out that evening and was in Hong Kong the next day shooting. So I didn't get a chance to really brush up on it. So, but I think there's a lot of the mind that's been unexplored, and the capabilities, we still don't know how much we can do. I doubt that we can do to the level that's in this movie, but who knows?
Wouldn't it be nice, though?
It would be pretty cool.
Be cool.
It would be pretty cool. It would certainly beat LA traffic, being able to lift the cars up in front of you and just throw them.
You've got Table for Three too, right?
Yeah.
Is that the one that you were filming before or after?
No, I shot that after.
Okay. What's that one all about?
Table for Three is it's a comedy about a guy who it's Brandon Routh who breaks up with his girlfriend and gets to an odd couple end up moving in with him and make his life hell.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Sounds interesting.
Yeah, it was a fun script.